Previously on Carrier Signal Decrypting.
Gusty Pants Outback Emporium. Superb. We have two missions here. Now, these are both in the same system, the Glushimer system. Alright, here we are on Glushimer. We are probably going to get interdicted as well. We need to get to Jemison Orbital. And full approach forward. Okay, so nice and careful. That should be all that should do it. Just going to make sure we go straight through that letterbox by before they have a chance to scan the craft. Number 26, we are quite far behind it. Yeah, a little bit. Give cargo. And we're all good. That is a lovely blue light. Or is it white? I'm not sure. Anyway, good afternoon, good morning, or good evening, depending on your locality and YouTube viewing schedule. Welcome to Acres Market, and my name is Commander Nova Kane. Now, today, we are not going to be flying Professor Chunk. We've got something a little bit sleeker. This is the Federal Assault Ship. She carries a bit of a punch, and I've covered her in my rank insignia, because I want everyone to know that I'm not quite elite yet. But we'll get there. She's also got loads of other stuff painted on her that I want to get rid of. But there we are. Whatever. She is a lovely ship. She handles incredibly well. But we're not here to talk about the Federal Assault Ship, although I could probably talk about her for quite a long time. Today, in this episode of Carrier Signal Decrypting, we're going to be talking about archaeology. And how you may use the skills to find random pieces of rubbish in space to make yourself a lot of friends and a lot of money. So, buckle in, do stay tuned, and very much hope that you enjoy the ride. Let's get started before we get a little bit too comfortable. So here we are in Acres Market. We're going to go to Starport Services, and like all other mission-related activities, we're going to access the bulletin board. And it's going to load up. And then we're going to get this twinkly little sound. Now, we talked in previous episodes about the icons for different kinds of missions. For example, this one is a courier mission. This one is a goodwill mission, assassination, piracy, etc. Archaeology, it's a bit kind of deceptive, really. It's just this one. It's just floating stuff, really. That's archaeology. What does it involve? We're going to click on caught in a moment and see what we got. So this one isn't terrifically well paid, 23,497. But if you're doing it in a sidewinder, you know, if you're just starting out, that's an enormous amount of money. So, not too bad. Let's have a look at what we've got here. I represent a group of specialist collectors, blah, 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 blah. They want some black boxes retrieved from the depths of space. In particular, my clients are interested in black boxes that come from civilian ships lost while under some sort of unprovoked attack. That's all fluff. I mean, it doesn't really matter. I mean, you can read that if you want to get all, like, roleplay in it. But you're really looking at this stuff. So let's have a look. Time left, 14 hours, 2 minutes. Pretty sure we can do that. In the Isleta system. Associated with is the commissioning faction. So the people who are going to be paying you for it. Obviously, we can go back. If we just click decline here, we can have a look on the right-hand side and see whether there's a major faction icon. Like here, we see that this one is a Federation faction. This one's independent. So we're going to get some street cred with the Dominion of Malachi, but the Federation at large isn't really going to care. But, you know, whatever. It's all good. We can also have a look at these ones as well, where there is a Federation icon. But one thing at a time. So, caught in a moment. We need to find a black box. Now, it will say stolen. This is super misleading. When you see stolen, you immediately think that you've got to go find some trader who, for some reason, has loads of black boxes and rob him. It's misleading. Obviously, with the way that the salvage law works in this game at the moment, this is the 1st of December, 3301. The way it works at the moment is that if you find anything, that's not been, quote, abandoned by another commander, then you've essentially stolen it, even if you just found it in the middle of nowhere. So it says stolen. You will get a fine if you get scanned having it, so we're going to be doing a little bit of smuggling flight. Have a look at the smuggling video for more info on that, if you want to, you know, get up to speed before we get started. But yeah, so don't worry about that too much. Quantity, one. Not really going to clarify that further. I think it's pretty clear. Minimum required exploration rank for archaeology missions, which again is a misleading title that I have invented for these kind of missions, but it sounds cool. You might need an exploration rank. This one, for 23 grand, it's not going to be high. It's aimless at the bottom rank, so you're fine. Relationship required neutral as a minimum. If you are... if this faction for some reason is angry at you, maybe you've been blowing them all up all day, then you're not going to be able to access it. But to be honest, no love lost. Effect on reputation, influence. So influence is how much the faction is going to benefit from your work. Not a lot. Not a lot. And likewise, you're not going to get a hell of a lot of street cred from them for doing it. But it's a good start. It's a good start. So ease letter. Now we can have a look. We've got a function here, open galaxy map. So the vast majority of archaeology missions will require you to go to somewhere else. So we're going to open the galaxy map and we'll see exactly where Isleta is. And there she is there. An independent system. We can see a solid blue line between Mulachi, where we are now, and Isleta. We've got some trade filter on at the moment for technology and other imperial slaves. Tracking the movements. So we'll turn those off because it's just getting confusing. So here we are. Isleta, we can see it's an independent system. We can also have a look at its economy here. Have a look at the Flight Academy video on the navigation panel if you want to know more information about what we're doing. Just turn all these on and we can see that it's yellow. It's an industrial system. We can also hover over it. It's an industrial and extraction economy. How does that compare to Mulachi, where we are? Industrial and agriculture. So there's a potential trade route there. So we could fill up on agricultural products, so obviously that would be food and drink and stuff like that, and take it over to Isleta. We might be able to make a little bit of a trade profit because we're going there anyway. However, for archaeology, and that this is what differs a lot from smuggling missions, is that when we have found this black box, we're going to have to bring it back here to Mulachi at Acres Market. That's a very important thing to consider. So we're going to accept that, and it's going to clunk over. Tum-ti-tum. There we are.
Remembering things best left forgotten.
So we can see here, when we found the black box, we can deliver it here and give cargo. Now, one thing to also consider is that you may have a black box in your hold already. You may have found it in an unidentified signal source that you randomly happened across before you even found the mission. The black box you're carrying will be acceptable for the mission. So if you're coming back, say you're going to smuggle in some black boxes or other stuff that you found, then check the bulletin board to make sure no one is actually looking for it, because then you can get paid more and get some reputation bonuses. So that's all right. So that's one thing to consider. Now we have here two options, decline or give cargo. Decline doesn't cancel the mission. It just means, would you like to give me a black box now? Well, I don't have any, so I'm going to decline that request, sir. Now we can have a look here. Remember, this is the icon for archaeology. What else have we got going? The secret some might tell. This is paying double the amount. And it's a federal aligned faction, so we're going to get some good reputation bonuses. Let's click on that. We'll see, we got an ancient artifact. Stolen. We talked about what stolen means. 5G Capricorni. Ancient artifacts. It's basically, it's like the Mona Lisa. Or the first ever London Underground train. Or something like that. Rather than one of these alien artifacts that seems to be cropping up all over the place. No, it's something very human, but very old and valuable, apparently. So again, where is 5G Capricorni? Is it one jump away? Is it in the direction we're going? So we can have a look here. So there's Mulachi over here. So this is going to be several jumps away. 20? No, it's only 20 light years. Good lord. Is that the best we can do? Let's have a look. What is our jump range, actually? I don't even know if I can find it on here. Hmm. We'll have to reconsider exactly the best way to get that. But we will accept that. That's fine. Groovy. So we're committed for 75 grand at the moment. Not too bad. Tum-ti-tum. It's going to click over. And then we can have a look here. That's all we've got going at the moment for Acres Market. So that's all we need. All we need now is to make sure that we have the bare minimum of equipment that we need, which is cargo space to put the stuff we find in. If you're really lazy, get some drones to go and pick stuff up. Ooh, the Empire does not like me. Ooh, dear. They just don't know me. They don't know me properly. So, drones if you're lazy, but we don't really need anything. That's it. We're all done. So, we are going to bring up our system map. And we are going to... What is that? I'm sure we can find a better route than that. Well, that's ridiculous. We're going to go to Isleta. I'm going to pronounce that in every single different way I can. We're going to launch. We're going to keep our lights on because it looks boss. Have a look around. Not pay attention. Probably should do a path plus in space flight. I've got to wait for this thing to go down. Right, lights off. Economical flight, I think, is the best way forward. Now, Federal Assault Ship flies like a dream. We're gonna be turning off the landing gear, make sure we're nicely aligned, and then boost out. Zoom, Type 9 there. Don't want to hit the Type 9. Whoosh, that was very cool. Nova Kane, stunt driver. There we are. So we've just left Maslock. That was a very, very quick way to leave Maslock. But if we keep going on this trajectory, we might actually go back into Maslock. And we don't really want that. Alright, so here we are. Isleta. Charging. 4, 3, 2, 1. Scan away, mate. I'm gone. Biff. So we are going to arrive in the system momentarily. What's this up here? We've got some sort of correspondence. Oh, there's another commander there. A friend request from Top Gun UK. Superb. Thank you very much, sir. I'll accept that. I'm a friendly guy. Okay, right now, when you accept certain missions, could be archaeology, could be smuggling, then you might see, we can just see there, if we go back on the comms panel, pirates will somehow get a wind of it and will say aggressive things to you. Bobby Apples. Well, Bobby Apples doesn't even really exist. Is it that Diamondback? I mean, we're not going to be bothering. Oh, he's a federal agent. Or she. Zachary Hudson. Right on. So really what we're doing now is we are waiting for unidentified signal sources. Now, some people will fly around and do all that and go all over the place, but you really, really don't need to. You can see here, they will automatically generate after a certain amount of time in the system, which is not very long. So, if you keep your speed low, it's going to be easier to actually jump into one when it appears. So that's a pro tip from your boy Nova Kane. So there we are. We could not overshoot it if we tried. We are in range. We're going to jump in and see. Remember, we're looking for a black box in this system. What have we got? Sensors are reading absolutely nothing at the moment. What kind of sensors have I got on here? An A4. Oh, we got one. Oh, it's Bobby Apples. No, oh dear. Probably should define some fire groups. Tum-ti-tum. That's what I got at the moment. Pacifiers are so overkill. Right. You can skip ahead for this. But I'm just going to take out this guy. Because I'm a lot more powerful than he is. And he's talking trash. Goodbye, Bobby. Nice to know you. Oof. Can really feel the oomph. Right. So that was a bit of a false start in terms of our unidentified signal sourcing. However, it's always a bit of a gamble. Why is my temperature critical? Oh, that might be why. It's a big old sun there. So we're just going to saunter away from the star. Now, sometimes unidentified signal sources will appear... Well, that's a weak signal source. So, weak signal sources, when you're doing archaeology, are also very, 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 very useful, because weak signal source is usually going to be some floating stuff rather than a starship. And remember, a black box is definitely under the floating stuff category. So that's not too bad. So we're just going to approach nice and easily. There's another one down there. We can just flip over, and that's another weak signal source. So, I mean, it doesn't matter. We're locked onto this one. And I've got a good feeling about this. Let's make sure we get to a good thing there. So we're just going to level off. The Federal Assault Ship's so responsive. It's just bonkers. Definitely a fan. Definitely a fan. So there we are. We just need to make sure we're under 1 megameter per second by the time we get to within 1 megameter of the signal. Simple as you can delegate it to a toddler. Alright, here we are, arriving. We're looking for little white pips. There are some white pips. Is it going to be toxic waste or some other tease thing that I don't want? Ooh, someone's had a bad day. 2 tons of wine. So, let's say you're just walking down a country lane and you found some bottles of wine. If you're Nova Kane, you're having it. Lovely. Maybe a Rioja, a bit of a Sauvignon there. I can lock onto it. Maybe it's not wine at all, maybe it's Lambrini. Whatever, it's free. Lovely. Charge, and then we rinse and repeat. Maybe without the rinsing. Have a sip of your favorite beverage. Ah, that made a very rude sound. And, Mir Nova. Cool name, bro. He says he's been sent to find me. He's going to try and say, oh no, don't do the job you're doing because of reasons that are incredibly important. And they're not really. I have a real beef with these people. Just leave me alone. Well, that's far away. So we're going quite quickly now. One pro tip you can do is just go onto the navigation pad. Oh, but there they are. So 2 unidentified signal sources appeared whilst I was going into that panel. So that's a really easy way of quickly finding if there are any signals nearby. And of course, it will update in real time, so you can just stare at that panel. It's not the most interesting thing to do, but you can do it to make sure that everything's going swimmingly. Unidentified signal source. We're going at about 1/5 the speed of light at the moment. Perhaps a little bit less. Just inching. Inching upon the signal. Remember, it's unidentified as opposed to weak. But, I mean, we already got some wine. That's my evening sorted. Couple of tons of wine. At least a few hours. Whew. Hum-de-dum. See, I would be interested if they brought in some sort of feature that if you got, like, a better frameshift drive or something, or better thrusters, that you could drop into signals when you're a little bit further away than 1 megameter, because this is just a pee in the space A. Man, come on. Right, here we go. That's what we want. Come. Right, type 7 and a Cobra 3. This is not really what we're looking for, but this is probably going to be something to play out, so I'd imagine if he's not a smuggler, we're about to find out whether he's wanted or not. He is not. So I imagine if we waited for a few seconds, then some pirates would appear and we'd fight them and it would all be very, very heroic. But that's not on the agenda today. We're looking for black boxes, sir. That time service is like, oh, hello. No. Oh, hurrah. So why is he not in Super Cruise? That always bothers me. I mean, like, surely it's going to take him almost literally forever. So we're just going to... Ooh, hello. Another weak signal source. That's what we're looking for. We are approaching maybe gonna be overshooting it. We don't want to, so we'll just have a look here. Ship is very responsive. Doesn't seem to be getting caught by gravity fields as bad as it was before when I was in Professor Chunk. So there we are. We're dropping speed quite rapidly. So that's quite good. Just need to make sure we keep it in the blue zone. Just down there. Keep it in the blue zone. And, you know, in a general way, you'll be alright if you stay in the blue zone. Obviously, it's designed to give you an idea of the best speed for your turning circle. But it's also quite helpful when you're looking to ensure you don't overshoot a destination. So at the moment, we're just have a look by eye. Are we going to get below one by the time our signal is within one? Yes, there we are. So now we can go full throttle because it's not going to put us over one because of some artificial gravity that the signal is creating. And biff. All right, we've got some white pips. We've got quite a few of them. Is it going to be something interesting? An ancient artifact. That is intriguing because remember, what are we looking for on our one that's 100,000 miles away? Just one of them. Now, methinks we'll be able to submit these and it will still be valid. This is what I claimed earlier in the video, and maybe I was lying. If I was, I was not intending to lie, but that's how these things happen. Let's get one of these future Maersk containers. Lovely. I mean, ancient artifacts are a relatively good find anyway. You can get a good few grand for them. I mean, it's not huge money, but it's not too bad. And done. Scoop away, and off we pop. Lovely jubbly. Hey, Top Gun UK has come online. Top fella. Send me a friend request. That's the ultimate move of brotherhood in my book. Or maybe it's an account to promote a new Top Gun film, but it's set in London. Because, according to films, that's the only place in this entire island where cameras are allowed. So, we've got some illicit cargo. That's everything we've picked up today, including the wine. Future wine is in pill form. That's good to know. So now we're just looking for... I swear he owed me more than that. Whatever. Ah! Weak signal source. There we are. So we've locked in. Where is it? It's down there. Would we have missed it without the use of the nav panel? Probably. Good thing to demonstrate my point. Now, this is probably the fourth or fifth signal source we've come across. Normally, it doesn't take this long. But there we are. We're going to overshoot it. So what we're going to do, we're going to use a little trick. We're going to unlock the destination. And... little trick there. You will stop incredibly quickly if you unlock your destination. I think it's something to do with your flight computer. It's trying to keep you at a good relative speed, but then you just overshoot it. You can use that for any destinations. It's a neat little trick. I'll probably do a dedicated video on that. Sort of super cruise flight assist off in a way. Very helpful. Now we're having a look. Coming in a little bit fast here. I think we might just... shave it. Some look. Yes. There we are. So, within any luck, we are going to find some black boxes or black box in this location. If we don't, I'm going to be ratty. Lots of white things there. Ooh, there was some sort of craft over there. More ancient paintings! I mean, you know, groovy, but... was there some sort of, like, art fair that went terribly wrong? Let's have a quick look. Very, very slowly. Get into this one. And lovely. Now, am I about to get a phone call? Let's find out. Nice and neatly hum-de-hum. Just bear in mind, obviously, that if you're carrying a significant amount of stolen goods, the police will not be too impressed if they find you with them. To be honest, I should be regarded as an art connoisseur rather than anything else. But whatever, I don't make up the rules. Now, the canisters can be quite fragile, so make sure that you don't try and be some sort of superhero. Keep to within 30 meters per second as a maximum. All done, scoop away, drive charging, super sexy boost noise playing.
Engage.
Thank you very much, Verity Croft. If you don't know who Verity Croft is, then have a look at the new voice packs that are coming out shortly. Verity Croft is the... Oh, hello! Smuggling suspect located, says the system authority Croft, moving to interdict. Have a go, mate, if you like. So yeah. Anyway, have a Google at Verity Croft, because she's the voice actress who is doing your in-ship communications. Oh, come on, Viper, give me a break, bro. All we need is another signal source, and then we can just get on. By the way, that plug for Verity Croft was not paid for, in case any of you are very cynical and think that I'm just some corporate shrill. Shouldn't need to say these things, but we live in a cynical, distrustful world. Right, okay, here we are. Salvageable wreckage. That's good. That's kind of what we're looking for. Pretty sure we're going to get interdicted. There we go. Yeah, we're just going to throttle zero. This is the police. Or this is a police stop command. Drop your throttle down, Commando. Now, why didn't we try to get away? Because... Right, scanning me. Fire some chaff off. Suspected smuggling crimes. Come on, bro. And can we do? Yes! We got away before he could get a complete scan on me. What we did is we used the chaff there to throw off his scanners. Now, we've lost the salvageable wreckage. It has despawned. So now we're just going to go back to flying around until it or something like it may reappear. Just having a look. Now we're just looking at the sun there at the top. Okay, our distance is increasing. If you find that your distance to the sun is rapidly decreasing, then be aware because you may be about to crash into the sun. And that may be something that would have a negative impact on your day. Just something to think about. Dum-de-dum. Just need to wait for a signal source to spawn. But in a few minutes, we've managed to get a hold on 10 tons of ancient artifacts and 2 tons of pill-shaped wine. Which is not too bad. Have we got one yet? No. This has taken its time. Come on. Pythons and adders and all sorts of things are hanging around. Federal agent, that's fine. Ooh! Weak signal source! Hurrah, hurrah! Where are we? There we are, we're down there. Now I'm getting most impatient. You will give me a black box! I don't care if it's a cardboard box painted black as long as they take it back at Acres Market. I got to get paid! A weak signal source and an unidentified. We're gonna go for the weak over the unidentified. Unidentified is probably gonna be some ships. That's not what we're looking for. We are archaeologists. We are space Indiana Joneses. Oh, and a little bit close to that one. Navigation. We're in the wrong one. Unlock destination. Relock. It's now 21.6 megameters away. Would we have overshot it? Yes. So there we are. Just taper off a little bit. Oh, the wedding barge is there. Thank you for broadcasting to the entire solar system. You smug, married people. Right, boosh. Oh, a Viper. System Authority vessel. Ah, it's a sting! Ugh. They're making this really hard for me. Oh, there's a black box. Ah, this must be our mission. All right, they've given me a 38 grand fine for illegal cargo. I'm not going to pay that. But this is what we're looking for. So obviously, this is the signal source that was generated for the mission. And just to make it very hilarious for me, they've added in a police craft. Which is, considering the fine I've earned is now more than this entire mission is paying, is a bit rich. But whatever, Frontier, that's fine. I ain't paying it. I don't even care. This very laid-back police officer just went, "Yeah, you're smuggling loads of stuff, you naughty boy!" And off he's gone.
Cargo scoop.
He's now off my scanners entirely. But whatever, it's all good. So, there we are. We have recovered a black box. That is our mission objective today. Hopefully, we'll be able to use the ancient artifact to also satisfy our other mission at Acres Market. So here we are, navigation. We're going to go back to Mulachi.
Frameshift drive charging.
I want to get a voice pack from the narrator for Unreal Tournament 2004. If you don't know what I'm talking about, YouTube that, man! Come on! Mulachi away! Ah, joyous. Successful run. Now, we've got illicit cargo, remember, it's still illicit, still classified as stolen. We've got a fine in the other system. These are both independent systems, so the fine from the other will not translate to this one. However, if we get scanned in this one, we're gonna have a bit of trouble. Now let's have a look. You might be thinking, Novocaine, why do I need to bother about fines? What's the point? Seriously. Well, I mean, if you don't pay your parking tickets, what's going to happen? You're going to end up getting taken to court. And it's a bit more severe here. You can see here, 37,824 credit fine. In the East Letter Nationalist Party. In 6 days, 23 hours and 57 minutes, that will turn into a bounty on our heads if it goes unpaid. To be honest, couldn't really care less. Because I'm just a bad boy. Oh, we're going to overshoot. Let's have a look. Navigation, can we unlock in time? No, we were caught by the planet's gravity field. Sometimes it doesn't work. But there we are. So we're just going to go back in the blue zone. Let's see where we are relative to the planet. Is it on the near side or the far side of the planet? I think it's on the near side. If it's on the far side, that's the pain. I can have a look there. Yeah, slightly closer, so we'll be alright. We're already being measured now in megameters. So we'll be alright. Acres Market. Welcome home, dear friend. I like how I'm currently allied with the feds. I mean, this isn't a federal station. But sometimes they say nice things like, "Welcome back, ally." But cheers, guys. Don't mind me as I smuggle hundreds of thousands of slaves into your station. Don't mind me, no, we're best friends. Alright, here we are, Acres Market. Now, we've kind of entered at a bit of a rough angle. So, we're going to have to manoeuvre a little bit. We're going to be doing a smuggling run today into the dock. Because obviously we're carrying a lot of illicit cargo, we can see there. Oh dear. And we've got a warning message there, just about the heat signature. So, if you haven't watched the smuggling video I've done for Carrier Signal Decrypting, then you wouldn't have seen how I approach stations when carrying some hot gear. We're getting a little bit close, actually. 6.5 kilometers away. A little bit close. We're not at the right angle, so we're going to put ourselves perpendicular to the station entrance. And basically, our objective here is to get ourselves positioned so we are in an exactly straight line. Now we're within 6 kilometers, so let's get this bit out of the way. If you forget to request docking permission, then this will all go wrong. So don't forget that. Otherwise, you will be called a noob. I just had this weird thought about Anubis. You know, the Egyptian god. Was he experienced in things? That's something for Wikipedia to answer. Right, here we are. We've got docking clearance. We've got 9.5 minutes to do it in. I think we'll be fine. Now we're just going to basically be making a beeline for that docking slot. So here we are. Boost in. Now obviously, don't attempt this if you're not confident.
What
just happened? Don't worry. Your YouTube connection is perfectly stable. But what happened on this end is that I ran out of hard drive space just as I was recording this video. Foolish me. I'm using GeForce Shadowplay and it updated it, right, just before I did the video. And then it decided to change all of my footage jump places. So the rest of this video is going to be a little bit of an audiobook. So close thy eyes and imagine the beauty behind the words. So we're going to continue and we're going to throw you some awesome sci-fi pictures instead. We'll just have to play the audio. But it's going to be fab. Stay with it and don't press dislike, please, because every time you do that, I get another grey hair. Not really. I have a few, but I quite like them, actually. But that doesn't mean you should press dislike. So, back over to you, pre-discovering your cock-up Novocaine. Over to you. Don't attempt this if you're not confident. Am I going to lose my ship? Hopefully not. Alright, a little bit nice and easy. Don't give them a chance to get a fix on you, landing pad 11. Do we... No, we're not going to be able to get that. We're just going to spin round. I've never known them to be able to scan you when you're inside the station. So, you can breathe a sigh of relief. However, there's a first for everything, so always be on your guard. If you see, scan, detect, then fire off some chaff. I don't need chaff, you say? Well, bully for you then. And there we are, down on the pad. Now, entering hangar, again, it's a little bit of a paranoia thing. Definitely can't scan you if you're inside the station's meaty part. Starport services. So we are going to do our standard thing, reload, so that's 200 for the chaff. And refueling, we're going to go to contacts. Wrong thing to press. Bulletin board. We can have a look, see what we got here. So we've got two here. Remembering things best left forgotten. Some black box. One out of one here because we've got it. Give cargo. Mission accomplished. And we will get the post-mission thing here. Reputation neutral. Influence in Malachi. This is the faction influence there. We can see a little blue bar. If you really want to know, we can go into the system status tab under status. We can see here Dominion of Malachi. Now on 10% relative influence. Lovely. We go back. Now, the moment of truth. Find the ancient artifacts of 5G Capricorni. Ha ha! We didn't even need to go. We found ancient artifacts over in his letter, and we that's it. We don't even need to go there. Give cargo. We found it. We found some. They're satisfied. I'm happy. And we've still got 9 left over, plus the wine. Now, let's have a look here. We've got some more that have appeared. So if it's for either wine or ancient artifacts, we'd be very lucky if it was, then we'd be able to complete the contract without even needing to do anything. So have a look. Black box stolen. That's another black box. We only have one. We don't even have one anymore, so there we are. So that's another black box mission. And that's all they've got going at the moment. So, not too bad. Now we can go to contacts. Now this is a Hudson control system, so it doesn't have a black market, so we're still carrying all of this gear. But if we went back to probably one of the independent systems, went back to Isleta, let's have a look here. There she is. Have a look at the system map. We can have a look. Olsen Station. You see, oh, that doesn't have a black market. Because they're now listed under facilities. So we have a look here. This one does. It's a hell of a long way away from the station. Probably at least like 5 minutes real time. Santi. I'm not going to go on through all these because it'll just take ages, but let's have a look. Accessing system data for Santi. It's in the secondary star. Contested by two federal powers. That's not good. We need to fix that. Let's have a look, right. That's quite far away. Doesn't have a black market. This one doesn't have a black market, so that's a waste of time. But, you know, you knock yourself out clicking on buttons and seeing where a black market is. But there we are. So, that was Archaeology. Done. Lights on. Love the lights. Love clipping the textures as well. That was a fan. Yeah, Zone 1. Just naming bits of the docking bay now. And the abyss! Where smoke comes from. That's the smoking shelter down there. I can bring my wine. I'm a bit of a party. So, that's what I'm going to be doing. Hopefully you will be doing a little bit of archaeology now that you know how to do so. It is one of the best ways to get started in the game if you are brand new, flying a little sidewinder. So, have a look at that. There are, of course, a multitude of different ways to spend your time in the galaxy of Elite Dangerous. So, please, make sure you subscribe and like the video if you liked it, and write to your MP if you didn't. And do stay tuned for additional episodes of Carrier Signal Decrypting, your missions guide, in addition to the Elite Dangerous Job Centre, all about your careers, and of course the Flight Academy on how to, you know, move around and stuff, because that's quite important. And yeah, really, really said it all there, said it all. I love the lights. Love them. Main beams. Brilliant. I have been Nova Kane. Thank you very much for watching. Do stay tuned for more episodes, and, well, we'll see you next time. Next time on Carrier Signal Decrypting. We visit the age-old tradition of buying people's affections with a dedicated section on goodwill and charitable missions. These sections of the game allow you to buy favor with various factions by giving them a little bit of spare change or some supplies. So make sure you stay tuned and learn how to get the inside track on essentially bribery. We'll see you next time.